So I was always interested in paleobiology. In fact, if you ask any paleobiologist why they study paleobiology, it usually goes back to the time before they were really able to walk. So I'd probably seen The Land Before Time 100 times before I was 3 years old, and then I had seen Jurassic Park 100 times before I was 7, and it only came out when I was 6, so that's a pretty major accomplishment, I think. And basically, I just could never imagine myself doing anything else, so I stuck with it, and here I am. So paleobiology is the study of ancient life, and the goal of paleobiology is to reconstruct the evolution of life on Earth. So paleobiologists study how life has changed through time in terms of its diversity, as well as in terms of how organisms use their environments, and also how and why those organisms aren't around today, why they went extinct. So I'm a paleobiologist who primarily studies vertebrates, and this work has taken me all around the world, from the western United States to China to the Amazon rainforest and even to Africa. So scientists actually didn't know what killed off the dinosaurs for a very long time, and there were a number of different competing hypotheses. Some scientists believed that dinosaurs were killed off because of changing climates, which led to the world getting colder and then dinosaurs froze to death. Some scientists believed that mammals actually outcompeted dinosaurs, primarily by eating their eggs. And some scientists believe that widespread volcanism or volcanoes were erupting, which was throwing ejecta up into the atmosphere, and that led to the downfall of the dinosaurs. So in the 1970s, Walter Alvarez and his father Louis Alvarez came up with the hypothesis that actually an asteroid had struck the Earth. And their hypothesis was supported by some evidence that they found in the form of an iridium layer, which was found all around the Earth at exactly the time that the dinosaurs went extinct. So iridium is an element that is really, really rare in the Earth's crust, but is a common component of asteroids. So the Alvarezes hypothesized that when the asteroid had hit the Earth, it threw a bunch of ejecta up into the atmosphere, and this included the iridium. And then the iridium, over the next few days and months, rained back down to the Earth, and then was deposited in the rocks that were on the surface at that time. And then this gave this iridium layer signal that the Alvarezes picked up on and then had made their hypothesis about the asteroid. However, even with all of this, there were a lot of scientists that were unsure of the asteroid hypothesis. But then the Alvarezes found the smoking gun, which was the form of an impact crater that was in the Gulf of Mexico. And this impact crater suggested that at exactly 65 million years ago, when the dinosaurs went extinct, a roughly 10 kilometer long asteroid plowed into the Earth. And now scientists all believe that this was the cause of the dinosaurs' extinction. So the KPG event is when the dinosaurs went extinct. So the K stands for Cretaceous, which is the period of time right before the dinosaurs went extinct. And PG stands for Paleogene, which is the period of time right after the dinosaurs went extinct. So KPG stands for that kind of line between those two periods of time. And that's kind of the exact moment that the dinosaurs went extinct. At the time that the asteroid hit, basically everything in the vicinity of the asteroid for hundreds of miles would have been completely incinerated instantaneously. And the asteroid hitting the Earth would have also created giant tidal waves that would have hit modern-day Texas and along the Gulf Coast of the United States, would have also triggered massive volcanism, so lots of volcanoes going off all at once, and massive earthquakes all around the world. And if that wasn't bad enough, the asteroid itself would have thrown lots and lots of ejecta and ash into the air, which would have blackened the skies for days, weeks, and maybe even months. And this would have caused all of the plant life to die out. So animals like this one behind me, Triceratops, which ate a lot of plants, if you may imagine, based on how big he is, wouldn't have been able to find enough food to survive. So if he wasn't killed in this initial event and all of these natural disasters that followed it, then he may have died out just from starving to death. So the consequences of the KPG event happening again would probably be as bad for us as they were for the dinosaurs. So a massive asteroid hitting the Earth, throwing lots of ejecta up into the air, causing lots of earthquakes, lots of volcanoes going off at the same time. Dinosaurs were one of the most successful groups of terrestrial animals that have ever walked the Earth. And they were around for a lot longer than we have been. So there's probably not a lot of luck for us if a giant asteroid hit the Earth today. So we can't know for sure how the world would be different if the KPG event hadn't occurred. But there's no reason to think that dinosaurs wouldn't still be around. They were around for more than 100 million years before the KPG event, so what, 65 million more?